Good morning, students. We have completed two parts of the lesson, mass media, history and mass media. And now we will continue with the lesson. And today we will start off with the part related to magazines and periodicals. I have already forwarded the notes for this particular lesson. And I hope all of you have started writing the notes in the workbook which is given to you. Because the extra questions, whatever has been given, that you have to put it down in your history notebook. And the workbook, the Navneet workbook which is given to you, you have to use it for writing the textual question answers. That way the workbook also gets used and you will be in a better position to revise all the objective type questions. Let us move ahead. Now today's part, we start with magazines and periodicals. Magazines and periodicals are, magazines and journals are periodical publications. Now these magazines and periodicals, they may be published weekly, bi-weekly, that means twice in a week, monthly, twice in a month, bi-monthly, quarterly, every 6 months or just once in a year, that is annual, like a report. Okay. So there may be some chronicles which may be published at no fixed time. Supposing any particular important event comes up, that time a particular chronicle can be published. Okay. Let us go ahead and I'll share screen with you now. Yes, magazines and periodicals. Now, let's talk about Bal Shastri Jambekar. You know who is Bal Shastri Jambekar? In last class, we have discussed that he was a person who was a first editor of the Marathi newspaper and named Digdarshan. And he also started a Marathi magazine called Digdarshan. And his birthday, 1st of January, is celebrated as Patrakar Divas. 6th January is celebrated as Patrakar Divas. Now we have periodicals called Pragati. This was edited by Trayambak Shankar Shejwalkar in 1929. Now it is not functioning. That's why the word defunct is used. It is not functioning now. But this was edited by Trayambak Shankar Shejwalkar. He also wrote regularly in this historical journal of Maharashtra's history and social movements. Today we have many periodicals which are devoted to Indian history. Marathi journals such as Bharatiya Itihas Ani Samskriti, Marathwada Itihas, Parishad Patrika are good examples of periodicals and journals which are there in Marathi. Let us move ahead, children. Magazines and periodicals also play a very important role because they deal with social aspects, political aspects, and they also provide a lot of information. So here you have concept map number 3, categories of periodical publications. Publications which are periodical publications, publications which are published weekly, bi-weekly, annually, monthly, 6 monthly, quarterly, etc. Let us talk about electronic or digital journalism. Electronic or digital journalism is a new concept and it's also known as online journalism. It is the current form of journalism where the editorial content is distributed via internet. Earlier, what we have seen is all printed or what is printed as newspaper, magazines, periodicals. But now that is not so. We are using computer, social networking, internet websites in order to provide information. This editorial content is distributed via internet and it is not like print or it's not printed or broadcasted. And these are modern, ultra modern periodicals form a part of the electronic of digital journalism. And many times you find that history is a prime subject of interest for these periodicals. And many web news portals, social media, web channels like YouTube, etc., they make historical content available to audience and readers. So you have all your web portals, social media, web channels, okay, they all come under what you call as digital journalism, electronic or digital journalism, is made possible because of these web channels. Now, there is information about how to access e-papers. And during the lockdown period, especially, many of the news people who are interested in reading the daily newspapers have resorted to what you call as e-papers. And I'll be forwarding to YouTube websites. I'll be two sites, and these you can view in order to see how you can read the daily newspaper use, that is e-papers, how to access e-papers. Okay, let us go ahead. And we have television. Let's go to the textbook now, children. Okay, another important, after magazines and periodicals, you have the next important mode of means of mass media, that is radio. And Indian Broadcasting Company, a private radio company, was the first one to broadcast daily programs in India. And the later that same company was taken over by the British government, and it was named as Indian State Broadcasting Service, ISBS. On 8 June 1936, this particular ISBS was renamed as All India Radio, AIR. And after independence, AIR became an integral part of the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, India. There are a lot of programs which are broadcasted, and it has been named as Akashvani. The famous poet Pandit Narendra Sharma suggested this particular name, and it's been called as Akashvani. Here is a flowchart, children, a concept map number 4, where you have the step-by-step information given as to how All India Radio came into being. Indian Broadcasting Company, a private radio company, was the first one to broadcast daily programs. Later on, it was taken over by the British government, named as Indian State Broadcasting Service. 8th June 1936, it was renamed as All India Radio. And after independence, it became an integral part of the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, India. It was named as Akashvani on the suggestion of the famous poet Pandit Narendra Sharma. Okay, so a lot of programs are broadcasted by the radio. All India Radio's Indian public service broadcaster, the radio vertical of Prasar Bharati, has been serving the Indian masses. The main intention is to inform, educate, and entertain its audience ever since it began. And its motto, All India Radio's motto, is Bahujana Hitaya, Bahujana Sukhaya. And radio still forms a very important means of mass communication, children, and entertainment also, because television is not available everywhere, plus it is also expensive. And you will find in small shops, in saloons, in beauty parlors, etc., one of the most important medium of entertainment is the radio. And today you have the Radio FM, Radio Mirchi, then there are several other Vivid Bharati programs which are broadcasted and which are liked by the masses. And so it is one of the important means of entertainment. AIR's home service has got 470 broadcasting centers all over the country, and it covers around 92% of India's area and 99.19% of the total population listens to the various radio programs. Okay, and AIR originates programming in 24 languages and 146 dialects. So in India, radio still is very, very popular. Let us move ahead. The progress of television in India. Let's talk about television. In India, television was started on 15 September 1959, and Delhi Doordarshan was started. On 2nd of October 1972, Mumbai Doordarshan was started. Color television was later introduced in India during the Asian Games. On 15th August 1982, color television was introduced. And there were only two channels children. One is the Doordarshan channel and the DD Metro that was in operation for right from the time of independence up to 1991. However, in 1991, several private channels were given permission and privatization played a vital role. And today, when you switch on your television, you are able to listen to or you are able to view lot of channels and also programs from all over the world. Okay, now let's talk about the content matter which is present in the television. You have various historical TV serials which are presented today. You have Chandragupta Maurya, then you have Porus, which talks about the fight between or battle between King Porus and Alexander the Great. And you have also various programs which are related to entertaining and they are to the liking of those who would like to view the recipes prepared, like food, khana, khazana, etc. So it caters to various interests of various individuals. Also, you have in the past there was one particular TV serial that was telecasted, that was Bharat Ek Khoj. We will talk about this in detail a little later. Let us move ahead. Many other television programs which are quite entertaining are the serials which are based on mythological stories like Ramayana, Mahabharata, or epics. Then you also have Discovery Channel and also National Geography Channel, which provides a lot of information related to the world in general, to the animal world, and various other information. And these videos are all prepared very beautifully, and they are telecasted. So many times people enjoy viewing them. Moving ahead, we have the concept map number 4. Mythological and historical serials like Ramayana, Mahabharata, Bharat Ek Khoj, and Raja Shiv Chhatrapati. These are some of the mythological and historical serials which are telecasted on the television. Okay. Now, all this while, we have gathered a lot of information about the various means or modes of mass media. Newspapers, television, magazines, periodicals, journals. Okay. Then you have the various electronic media that can be used for mass communication. Like even your mobile phone comes under mode or means of mass communication now. Okay. Now, why do we actually need mass media? It's a very important question, children. A 4-mark question. We need mass media in order to allow free flow of information to all strata of society. You're sitting at home, but you get information about what's happening all over in the world, whether it is political, economic, social, something to do with entertainment. Everything is available on your mobile phone now. So there is free flow of information to all strata of society. A rich man, a poor man, a vegetable vendor, anybody and everybody who has access to internet can get all the information. So there's free flow of information. Editorials, various columns, supplements, the news are all parts of newspapers. So again, there's a lot of information available. Now, when it comes to editorials and writing in the newspaper, several journalists, reporters, okay, even readers, they also use this as a platform in order to voice their opinion, especially in a democracy. Newspapers and readers' opinion play a very important role. Public opinion plays a very, very important role, children. Newspapers can help in making democracy. Newspapers can help in making democracy stronger. Newspaper prints current news and the reader gets additional information, so he gets better insights about current news. So all this is about newspaper, how newspapers become very important. That's why, children, we have earlier discussed that newspaper is also called as the fourth pillar of democracy. Television. Television is an audiovisual medium. You can see and you can hear. So it's called audiovisual medium. And where the newspaper, we are only able to read the newspaper. Television crosses the limitations of the newspaper and the radio, and we are able to actually view the event as it happens. Magazines and periodicals also publish research findings which are useful to students and other researchers. It gives information about the current trends that are prevalent in the society. Radio and television broadcast several programs which also entertain people. So these are the some of the this is the importance of the mass media, and that's why we are able to that's why mass media is very, very important to get information, to voice one's opinion, to make democracy stronger, to get better insights about current news. Also, many of this mode of mass media, they are audiovisual, and therefore they are really very, very effective. Magazines and periodicals publish research findings, and television and radio broadcast several programs to entertain people. Let us move ahead. Critical understanding of information received through mass media. Although we receive a lot of information, for example, on our mobile phone, many times we don't know whether they are really true. Mass media, any information received through mass media, therefore, needs to be reviewed critically. The news or information that is there in the mass media may not actually represent the exact truth. Therefore, we need to be very, very careful. We don't know whether they are, how authentic they are, how true they are. Okay, this again, there's a very important, a very famous event that happened in Germany. A newspaper called Stern, okay, there's a weekly German magazine, had purchased a lot of handwritten diaries of Adolf Hitler. Children, Adolf Hitler was a dictator of Germany, and he was a person mainly responsible for the Second World War. His policy of expansion and his desire to control many nations and bring it under the control of Germany resulted in the Second World War. So Hitler was the dictator, and he had the habit of writing diaries. And even after the World War was over, Second World War was over, many of the media people were interested in knowing more about Hitler's personality. And a few diaries were procured, and they were sold to various publication companies. And they claimed that these diaries were personally written by Hitler himself. And you know how the media people are, they want news, they want some hot stories, okay? And so therefore, when the diaries were received, the Stern newspaper weekly magazine decided to publish this, and they started publishing it. But what happened was, there was some kind of scientific investigation that was done, and it was found that these diaries were not real. They were all forged. Somebody else had actually copied the handwriting, and they were all forged. And therefore, this particular newspaper, this magazine, earned a very bad name or a very bad reputation. And therefore, one must be very, very careful about the information published by the media. Here you have the picture of the diary which were they were procured, and the Stern newspaper, that is the German weekly magazine, not the newspaper, but the German weekly magazine got a very bad name internationally for publishing the so-called Hitler Diaries on 28th of April 1983 edition. And the forgeries, that is the person who had actually copied the handwriting and had presented these diaries as written by Hitler, was none other than Konrad Kaujo, who had created the journal between 1981 and 1983. And when this was discovered, okay, the magazine earned a very bad reputation, and the magazine editor had to actually resign, and this led to a major scandal. And it was considered to be a very, very negative thing that happened in German journalism. And because of this crisis, the magazine's credibility was damaged and its reputation reached the lowest level. It took the magazine 10 years in order to regain its position and reputation back. So therefore, children, one has to be very, very careful when one thinks about posting anything on social media or reading anything which we receive in social media. We must be very, very careful. Mass communication involves television, internet, billboard, then magazines, newspaper, leaflets, social media, and radio. Children, we must be very, very careful, and we must take certain precautions while we use the social media. Being a very responsible citizen, there are 9 blunders that we should try and avoid when we are using social media. One is posting personal content matter. Do not post personal content matter, because that can go against you at some point of time or the other. Controversial matters, like for example related to religion or caste or material which can lead to any kind of social disturbance, we should avoid posting our views when the matters are really controversial. While sharing even other people's information, we must be very, very careful. Similarly, publishing too much of information at a certain point of time again can be dangerous. Leaving security exposed, for example, putting up information like bank data, localization or purchase of goods, whatever we have purchased, all this should not be shared on social media, because sometimes our status, our financial positions, that gets exposed, and puts a question mark on our security. Okay. Then you have clicking everything you see. Do not believe everything that you read on social media. A lot of information which is shared, especially they may not be true, and there may be also virus that can infect your computer. Poor writing, especially when you are putting up something on the social media, try to check whether whatever you are putting up is the language in which you are actually posting the material should be grammatically correct. Not being professional, that is another one thing that you should avoid. For example, a nutritionist shares on social media her pictures and a video of herself eating and drinking things which she tells her patients not to consume. If she herself has pizza, burger, and then she tells her patients not to eat that, then again that is being not being professional. Not replying to users. Social media is used by people in order to advertise their brands. So therefore, if you are a businessman, you must try to reply to your users, and there must be good interaction build up between the users and the businessmen. So one must try not to avoid the comments of the users, but reply to them and even appreciate them, thank them for their support. So these are the 9 points that you should be you should take note of while you are using any kind of social media. Okay, because these are all important means or modes of mass communication. Mass media and professional opportunities. That is the next point that we will cover. Mass media and professional opportunities. As we saw that there are various modes of mass communication, and so therefore we have newspapers, radio, television, they are important fields of mass communication. Many professional opportunities are available, children, in this field of mass media. For example, one can be field reporters. Okay, you can report current news, but sometimes you have to take the help of history, when there is a particular event happening and there is a background to be presented of an event that has taken place in the past, then newspaper reporters should have good knowledge of history so that they can get additional information and they can correlate it with the current news and present it. Okay, so the newspaper reporters who are reporting, they have to take sometimes the help of history in order to unfold the background of events that have taken place in the past. Reporters also should have very reporters with historical knowledge. Newspapers print columns about historical information appearing under headings such as 50 years ago what happened, 100 years ago what happened. Okay. And these such columns are based on historical documents or written history. For example, if it is a centenary celebration of a great national leader or of a great national event like the Quit India Movement or any other important event has taken place and 50 years have passed or 100 years have passed, information about all that is given in detail. Many times a whole page in the newspaper is devoted to presenting this information, and when the newspaper reporter has to write about it, that particular reporter should have a very good knowledge about this historical information and about the background as to when this particular event took place. Okay, so he must have information about economic, social, political events in the past and also events of historical significance. Radio jockeys. Now, as I told you that radio plays a very vital role or it's an important means of mass communication. Akashvani has preserved all the recordings of all the speeches that have been delivered by the various prime ministers of India. It invites historians as experts for discussions on various occasions such as anniversaries, birth or death anniversaries of national leaders. And if it's a birth anniversary or death anniversary of a national leader, that particular leader's very important speech on a very historic occasion is actually put up on the radio program, as a part of the radio program. Okay, lectures on the contribution of various national leaders needs to be supported by historical information. Again, it must be authentic. And programs like On This Day in History is also an integral part of the daily programs of Akashvani. You must have even seen this in the newspaper. On This Day in History, the importance of the day, important happenings which have taken place on this day, that's put up in the newspaper. Similarly, Akashvani programs also talks about the importance of the day. Programs that are there on the television channels. Television channels telecast various programs, okay, like mythological and historical serials like Ramayana, Mahabharata. These two serials, there was retelecast, especially during the lockdown period, in order to entertain people. And you have a very, very important TV serial, television serial that was telecast some years ago, children. Bharat Ek Khoj, a very, very, it's really a very, very good TV serial. And again, Raja Shiv Chhatrapati, that also attracted a very large audience. Whenever such serials are telecasted, for example, now you have Rana Pratap or you have Porus. While producing these type of programs, a lot of accuracy must be maintained. That is, the director and the producer, the story writer, everyone has to play a lot of important. They must be very careful about presenting the environment, outfits, weaponry, lifestyle, then the type of language used, etc. They must have a proper knowledge in order to make it really very, very effective. Okay, and if a person who has knowledge of history here becomes very important, because they get a chance in order to be a part of the team which is producing these serials on the television channel, for the television channel. Then one can be a writer also. One needs to have a deep understanding of history and of a concerned period. And currently channels like Discovery, National Geography Channel have opened a rich treasure of global history for the audience. Okay. So many times these history channels, they try to present how a particular type of industry started, what kind of progress was made, how was a production of a particular thing, how a production of a particular thing happened in the past and how it has progressed in the modern times, etc. The History Channel and National Geography Channel enables us to view historical and geographical wonders sitting in one's own house. Then there are also serials about ancient monuments, forts, history of empires, then history of culinary arts. That is now I showed you one particular picture of Khana Khazana or food. Those are foodies and would like to watch recipes prepared, cuisine prepared in the other parts of the world or other parts of the country. They're watched by large number of people with great interest. Okay, so people with deep knowledge of history in these respective fields are always in great demand, and that is how professional opportunities are available in the field of mass media. So children, here we come to the last part of the lesson, where we have something related to what you call as Bharat Ek Khoj. Now, what is this Bharat Ek Khoj? I'll share screen with you and we will have a look at it from the text in the textbook, what information is given. Okay, Bharat Ek Khoj is a serial telecasted by Doordarshan, and it has a special place in the history of Indian television serials. Now, what is this? What is the story based on? In this television serial is based on The Discovery of India, a book written by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. And this particular TV serial was directed by Shyam Benegal. What exactly is the subject matter of this particular TV serial? This TV serial tries to present the history of India right from ancient times to the modern period. Right from Harappan civilization onwards till modern India, that is till the Indian independence, everything related to Indian history has been dealt with in this TV serial. And it helps us to know better the social, cultural and political history of India of the respective periods. So it starts from the Harappan civilization, moving to Vedic history, Mahabharata, Ramayana, that time period, then Mauryan period, the various invasions in India, the Turk-Afghan invasions, Mughal period, the contributions of various Mughal rulers, right from Babur to Aurangzeb, Bhakti movement, then the time period of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, the reform movements in India, the entire Indian struggle for independence. All this is being dealt with. That is right from ancient India to India of the modern period. Everything gets covered in this one TV serial. And Roshan Sheth, the actor who played Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru in the Jawaharlal Nehru in the serial, also happens to be the narrator who on and off comes into picture, and he explains to us and various parts of the story. That is, the episodes are all dramatized, and sometimes beautiful folklore, music, speeches are all incorporated into this TV serial. And that is why the serial was admired in all parts of India, because of its comprehensive, that is all inclusive historical perspective of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, and also its equally good visual presentation. So Bharat Ek Khoj, I am putting up one particular YouTube link, and I think you will watch it and you will get interested in watching all the episodes of this particular wonderful TV serial, that is Bharat Ek Khoj, because that gives us a very good idea of the history of India right from the ancient times till Indian independence. So we come to the end of the chapter, children. We come to the end of this particular chapter. Question answers I have already posted yesterday, and some question answers have been given to you. Some extra questions also have been added in that. And the part two, that is question answers, that is give reasons, short notes, and some more extra questions and concept maps I will be adding on, and we'll be posting it very soon, maybe tomorrow or in 2 days time. Be prepared to with the chapter. During the weekend, I will be forwarding a Google form, and like History of India, Indian Arts, Part 1 and Part 2, there were two Google forms that were given to you, and many of them have submitted this Google form. Whenever you submit this Google form, children, remember, you have to look into the textbook, read the textbook, find the answer, and then fill the Google form. I'm not expecting you to learn it by heart and then go ahead with the Google form. This is basically to prepare you to read the textbook and understand the material given. So reading the textbook once or twice becomes very important. So while filling the Google form, you keep your textbooks open, look into it, and then fill the Google form. That will give you a better idea. Filling up all the question answers for chapter 4 and chapter 5 in your history workbook, Navneet workbook, which is given to you. I want everyone to start using the workbook. Thank you, children. Stay home, stay safe, but utilize your time well, and see to it that you start preparing for your assessments, which will be held once the school reopens. You will have an assessment, so be well prepared for it. Thank you.